Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam, Allahumma rabbi zidni ilma, sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam, Ameen, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. This lecture is of concepts of testing of hypothesis. Testing of hypothesis means a claim that we want to test or to test a claim. A very important piece of advice for me and for everyone. Decent, modest and pious people. Never even think to wear indecent and immodest dresses. We should be well-mannered. The background knowledge for testing of hypothesis. To be good at testing of hypothesis, we must be good at binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, normal distribution and sampling and estimation. Types of questions in testing of hypothesis. This question is from June 19, question 3, paper 7-1. Sumrita has a six-sided die. She suspects, and this is very important. She wants to check the die. She suspects that it is biased so that it shows a six less often than it would if it were fair die. See, what if the die was fair, then the probability of number 6 would be 1 upon 6. But she suspects that it is biased and it shows a 6 less often. That means probability of 6 is less than 1 upon 6. And this is the claim we want to test in this question. P is 1 upon 6 if the die is fair. And if the die is biased, the p is less than 1 upon 6. And this is the claim. She decides to test. This is the testing of hypothesis. The die by throwing it 30 times. This is basically n of binomial. And noting the number of throws on which it shows a 6. It shows a 6 on exactly 2 throws. This is the test value. I will discuss these terms later in this lecture. So these types of question comes in testing of hypothesis. And this question is of binomial distribution. Another example, this question is from November 20, paper 6-2, question 6. A biscuit manufacturer claims that on average, 1 in 3 packets of biscuits contain a price offer. The P of binomial is 1 upon 3 because there are two outcomes. Jerry suspects that the proportion of packets containing the price offer is less than 1 in 3. He thinks the proportion is less than 1 upon 3. In order to test the manufacturer's claim, in this question, the claim is this is the claim. This is H0, this is H1. I will discuss these terms later in this lecture. This is the claim. Don't worry about these terms. Just ignore these terms right now. We'll discuss these terms later in this lecture, inshallah. In order to test the manufacturer's claim, he buys 20 randomly selected packets. This is n of binomial. And this is the test value. Carry out the test at 10% significance level. We'll discuss this later as well. Another question, this is from November 17, paper 7-1, question 7. In the past, the number of cars sold per day at a showroom has been modeled by a random variable Poisson distribution with lambda 0.7. Following an advertising campaign, it is hoped that the mean number of sales per day will increase. Now, this is the claim. So, here lambda is 0.7 and it says that lambda will increase. In order to test the at the 10%, this is just ignore this thing, we'll discuss this later. Whether this is the case, the total number of sales during the first 5 days after the campaign is noted. So we just need to check. sale for 5 days. So lambda is 3.5 and here 3.5. This is the claim. And we want to check this claim. And we have to check this. Another question of Poisson. June 20, paper 6-3, question 3. The number of customers who, this is Poisson, right? Who visit a particular shop between 9 a.m. and 10 a.m. has the Poisson distribution. In the past, the value of lambda was 5.2. Following some new advertising, the manager wishes to test whether the lambda has increased. This is the test. And this is the claim. We have to check whether lambda has increased or not. He chooses a random sample of 20 days. So 5.2 is for 1 and for 20 is lambda. So 104. And finds the total number of customers who visited the shop between 9 a.m. and 10 a.m. is 125. This is the test value. And you all know when lambda is greater than 15, we always use normal approximation. So this question will be solved by normal approximation. Next example, from this is from June 20, paper 6-2, question 2. In the past, the mean height of plants of a particular species has been 2.3. This is mu. This is continuous distribution. Measurable quantity. A random sample of 60 plants, this is N, of this species was treated with fertilizer and the mean height, 60 plants, was found to be 2.4. This is the test value. And assume that standard deviation is 0.4. This is sigma. Carry out the test at 2.5% level of whether the mean height of plants treated with fertilizer is greater than. Here we have to check this thing, whether mu is greater than 2.3 or not. So this is the claim. And we have to check this claim. And by the way, since population is unknown, and N is large, so use CLT, central limit theorem. And according to CLT, X bar is approximately normal with mean 2.3 and sigma is 0.4 square. Sigma square over NS, which is 60. Another example of testing of hypothesis. This is from March 20, paper 6-2, question 3. In the past, the mean time taken by Farida for a particular daily journey was 39.2. This is mu, population mean. Following the introduction of a one-way system, Farida wishes to test whether the mean time for the journey has decreased. She wants to test whether mu has decreased. So this is 39.2 and mu less than 39.2. And this is the claim. So these types of questions come in testing of hypothesis. These are some examples. Last example, the mean weight of bag of carrots in mu kilograms. An inspector wishes to test whether mu is 2.0. He just want to test whether mu is 2.0 or not. This means change, whether mu is 2.0 or not. So this is the test in this case or in this example. I will discuss discrete distributions in my next lecture, inshallah. Good luck and Allah Hafiz.